Today is the final episode of season one. Now, as I mentioned, I'm not so sure what season two is going to look like because I'm not sure about my living situation with season two. So we don't know what next summer is going to look like, but I do want to try to bring as many episodes as I can. If I can't bring that many, a short season is still a season, nevertheless. For episode 11, the final episode, I of course wanted to do something that was new and different. Something like that's never been done before. And so, for episode 11, I am going to go to my grandmother's house. Okay, you're probably going like, Bob, you did that in episode 1. Okay, guys, I am going to my grandmother's house, but how I'm going to get there has never been done before. The route that I'll be taking is not a different neighborhood. It's not going to be like a Montrose or a Fullerton, a Foster. It's not going to be any of that. I'm going to try to take the streets less and the alleys more. That's right. I am going to be going up and down the many alleys that I come across just to get to my grandmother's house and back. I know that alleys can be like rather iffy and shady and all that crap. I know the truths and the myths, but here's the main thing. Alleys are a gold mine of oddities. Heck, if you remember from episode 1 when like the only oddity I found was like the Oreo cookies and I mainly found like a lot of sidewalk faces. I'm hoping that episode 11 could be like the redeeming episode. Like, I'm going back to my grandmother's house, but I'm hoping this time around I can finally bring in more oddities. In fact, like, I can have, you know what, I could have a whole spin-off where I just walk up and down the many alleys. In fact, that's what I had to do for some of the episodes, like episode 7 and episode 8. When I was heading home, I was like, I don't want to walk down the neighborhood, I want to walk down the alley. And there are tons, like, I highly guarantee you'll find a lot of weird, random, wacky stuff. And no, it is not condoms and hypodermic needles. There are far more interesting things in the alleys than just that. Get ready for the final episode of season 1 of Outdoor Oddities as I go back to my grandmother's house, only taking the alleys. So since this is the first time doing the alleys, for a walk, I don't want to do anything creative or extreme. I'll probably do that next time. Even though I was hoping that this would be the final time that I would ever go to my grandmother's house, because I've been going to my grandmother's house for a long time. I think it's time I give it a rest. Anyway, so right now I'm walking along what the frick? Hope we got that one. There was like a fly in front of the camera. So right now I'm walking along like a horizontal alley. Now, if there was no horizontal alley, or let's say there's like a blockage, I would have to walk down a vertical alley, much like this one. So I'd have to walk down it, and then I find another vertical alley, and I'll walk up it. But seeing how I just have the horizontal alley, I'm gonna keep going down the horizontal alley. Look at this example right here. I mean, like, that's half of an alley, but there's like no way to like get in. I mean, it goes right to like this car lot, but like it just ends right there. Like, so that's a very pathetic alley. It's not even, shouldn't even be considered as an alley. This, on the other hand, is an alley. You know what I love about these two warning posters about rats? I mean, you got this one right here where it's like, oh, but rats are nice, they're cute and cuddly. No, they're fucking vicious and poisonous and venomous. They'll bite you to death. Two things that I did not put a count into this walk. One, many of these alleys can lead into dead ends. And I have to be like, oh, I gotta go out. And the second one is, some of these alleys could lead in, ooh.
Hello.
Some of these alleys could lead into like someone's property, and of course I have to backtrack, get out of there, because I don't want to be accused in being a trespasser or anything. You know, there was two things that I was hoping for on this walk: a good amount of oddities and hardly any people. Wait a minute. That's every time I go for a walk. And there's the word dumb. That's me right now. I'm dumb. There. Yeah, it's right there. Dumb. Well, it's 11:40 right now, and all I can say is I'm starting to have Blick flashbacks. Oh, wow, look at this house. It's got like a circle. Look at that. That's really cool. The abundance of chairs and shoes that I find in alleys is starting to become as common as bald men and dog walkers. And these guys are like, why are you gonna be like that, bro? Alright guys, I reached my destination at 12:40, so 2 hours, 40 minutes. I couldn't stay because when I reached my grandmother's house, a hauling truck just happened to arrive around that time. But I was also able to visit, oh my God, I just saw, there's an outdoor oddity right across from me. I was able to see my mother's brother, and a hauling truck just showed up the minute I got to his house. Yeah, like ever since my grandmother like passed away a couple of years, and there's like stuff of hers that no one wants, so it's like, why still have it? But that's family business. It's between my family. Okay, guys? Anyways, let me show you that oddity I pointed at. Look at this right here. Office chair. You know, I've been keeping my mouth shut about this, and I think it's about time that I've said something. I miss iTunes. iTunes was so convenient. Even more convenient than what YouTube Music is, that's what I had to turn to. Like, with iTunes, downloading music was a breeze, and like, if I needed to like rename the song, I can just do that. Now with YouTube Music, I download the music, and if I have to rename it, I have to delete the song from the YouTube Music and rename it on like the drive and then put it back in. That's such a hassle. Unlike iTunes, I have to put a hotspot on my phone so I can listen to my music via iPod. If something were to happen to the hotspot, the music would stop. That would never happen with iTunes. And sometimes if I'm listening to my music, this will happen like once in a while, the music would just, oh god damn, I got hit by a fly. The music would just stop for no reason whatsoever. Like, did like the hotspot fuck up? No, it just stops. And then I have to like, oh, that's another thing. Like, sometimes like when I go onto like right here, I know you can't see it. There you go. I would hit that triangle button. That triangle button is of course play. I would have to hit like the little circle thing, you know, on the line. And it's like, why go through that hassle? You know, when I had iTunes, I never had this problem. I just hit the triangle and the music would play and it would never stop. Going back with the pausing and YouTube Music, sometimes I pause my music for like about 5 seconds, and then when I try to press play, I have to press it like 3 times. With iTunes, I just press play and it goes back to the song. Another thing that made iTunes so much better than YouTube Music. Okay, so I have a bunch of songs on my iPod. When I had iTunes, I would hit shuffle, and it would just keep on going and on. There'd be no end. But when it comes to YouTube Music, it only plays, let's say, 55 songs of the whole shuffle list, and it comes to an end. And it's like, I have more songs than that, but I have to go back and hit shuffle again. Like, why? You know, it's amazing what Sesame Street has gone through over the years. I mean, growing up, it's always been ABCs, 1, 2, 3s, colors and shapes. Now it's Elmo getting pissed off at a rock and Bert and Ernie getting married. You guys know what that is right there, right? That's a chicken. That is so cool. Look at that. That's a chicken. Wow. Chickens are the best, man. Thank you. All right, everyone, I got back into my house at 3:03, so that was 5 hours, 3 minutes. This is the last remaining of my smart water bottle, but I did the smart choice and went to 7-Eleven for an extra large big gulp. Delicious. So, the conclusion of this episode. I was hoping that there would be a difference, but it really more or less was the same. I mean, yeah, I did find more oddities, but it was just like... I was quite disappointed. You know, maybe I should have gotten a little creative. Then again, I probably wouldn't have gotten home at such an early time. I know many people, they say things about alleys that they're shady, that you really shouldn't walk down upon. There could be, like, bad people, hypodermic needles, condoms. You know what I've mentioned in the intro. But for me, I know that alleys are a gold mine for oddities. Today was a hit or miss. Yes, I did find more oddities than the first time I walked to my grandmother's house. But I also stated that I want to make this the last time I ever go to my grandmother's house. I mean, pardon me. The last time I ever walk to my grandmother's house, because it's starting to become, like, it's boring. It doesn't have, like, the same spark anymore. I actually didn't find that many oddities as I was hoping to find. And yeah, I got some, like, reminiscence of Blick, where there was, like, more people than oddities. And it's just, like, I saw more people walking in the alleys than more cars driving in the alleys. That's messed up, man. That's... Oh, God. Oh, man, that really hurt it. Oh, man, I ruined that. Or keep that one. I'm gonna keep that one. That's messed up, man. you know, it's the worst thing about walking is when you discover that you have a hangnail. And now I know why they call it a hangnail, because it hangs from your nails. It's hanging 10 on your nails. Bad joke, I know, I'm sorry. And it's like you can't do anything about it. You can't clip your hangnails when you're on a walk. Unless, of course, you just happen to have this in your pocket. What are you, Doctor Who? What's the title? It's going to be a long one, but... Alleys, or Allie, is spelled A-L-L-E-Y. But of course, if you take out the E-Y, you don't say it as al, you say it as all. Unless you're one of those people that don't say it envelope, you say it envelope or schedule. Yeah, those are facts. The title is Allie's, more like all this walking for nothing. Because that's what it was. Like... As I said, I did find oddities, but it was just like, it was pretty much the same thing. Like, if the first walk wasn't as hot, I probably would have, like, found a good number of oddities. I mean, I did find the sidewalk faces. That's another thing. I don't think I found any sidewalk faces on this walk. Wow. There you have it, folks. Outdoor Oddities, Season 1. How was it? Outdoor Oddities was fun. Like, I had a great time. Like, I learned a lot with Premiere Pro. I tried, like, various effects, and I had, like, all these ideas. It was a good learning experience, and I look forward to making more video projects. It's not perfect, but it's not the worst. As for you guys, I hope that you enjoy this series. I hope that I was able to entertain you in some way, that you were able to see, like, a different side of Chicago. It was just, like, areas that you've walked to that you've never really, like, thought about. You can, like walk down, like, the streets that I walked down, like, oh, this is where Bob saw that mug in the tree, or this is where Bob saw the... like those masks on the 606 and stuff like that. I really hope that you guys did enjoy this series. And I do want to try and bring, like, season 2. And if you guys have any ideas of where I should walk to, I am more than open to hear your suggestions. Just make sure it's not a bad area. I do not want to walk into an area and then have the fish face from Star Wars goes like,
"It's a trap!"
Yeah, you see, that's what I mean, guys. And I really hope that you guys like enjoyed it, whether it was for my jokes or just the oddities of Chicago, or even just like the scenic views of Chicago, or maybe all of it. I am going to try to get a season 2, and if season 2 is only like about 5 episodes, I mean that still counts. That's still accountable. But yeah, I enjoyed this series. It was fun. I'm glad I was able to like finally do something with these walks, like turn them into something. And I hope you guys have like good fortune, great rest of your day. I hope you enjoyed these videos, and I hope you are looking forward to seeing as I grow my channel even more with videos. And I really hope in the future, more sooner than later, YouTube becomes lenient again. I hope YouTube like realizes that it shouldn't cut itself on the limitedness that it can give its creators creative freedom, and that I can upload these videos without the fear that they might be taken down. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this. Hope you're looking to see more. I am your host, Bob Miller, and this is the end of Outdoor Oddities Season 1.